Hi everyone, welcome back to our another Python project. And in this Python project, we will create a Python program so that we can track phone number and find the location in Google Map using Python. For this Python project, we will be installing some Python packages and then we will need a phone number which one we want to track. Now in a few moments, I will show you how to do that. But before we get started, if you guys are new in my channel, then please subscribe, like this video and press the bell icon for the future videos. That's it guys, let's get started. First open your favorite code editor and then you have to create a new project file. Here you can see that I have created one track location, and inside this project folder you have to create two separate Python files. So let's create our first one. So click right and from our new we have to select our Python file. And here you have to give the Python file name and it will be main.py. That's it. So after this one, now we have to create another Python file. So that's why again go to our project folder, select right, you have to create a Python file and then give a name. Here inside this file I will put a phone number which we are going to track, so that's why the Python file name will be myphone.py. That's it. So guys, here you can see that we have created two different file. One is main.py and another one is myphone.py. And here inside this myphone.py, first I'm going to create a variable and it will be number. And here I'm going to insert my phone number, which one I'm going to locate. And guys, please pay attention, the phone number I'm using for this project is my personal phone number. So for some security reason, I'm going to hide the phone number. That's it. Here you can see that I have my phone number here. So after our this phone number, now we have to go to our main.py, and here first we have to import a Python package which is phone numbers. So now we have to install it. So for installing, let's go to our terminal, and here we have to write pip install phone numbers. That's it, and then type enter. In a few moments, the package will be installed in your computer. Guys, here you can see that we have successfully installed our phone numbers. Now, after installing the phone numbers, we have to import the phone numbers in our project file. That's why we have to write import phone numbers. Now, after importing our phone numbers, we have to import the number variable which we have created in our myphone.py. So that's why we have to write from myphone import and we have a number variable. That's it. First, from our this phone number, I'm going to extract the country name. Okay, so for extracting the country name, we have to import another module from our phone numbers, and this one will be geocoder. That's it. So first we have to divide these phone numbers into some separate parts. So for doing this, here we have to create a variable, and here the variable will be pep number, and here we have to call our phone numbers and parse, and here we have to give the name of the variable which variable is containing our number. So here you can see that our this number variable is actually containing our number, so that's why we have to write here number. That's it. And then we have to extract the country location, so that's why we have to create another variable and it will be location. And here we have to call our geocoder dot description for number. That's it. And here we have to give two parameter. One parameter will take our this divided variable, and then another variable will take a value for our language and it will be English. That's it. Now here first I want to see the country location, so that's why we have to print the location. That's it. Now if I run the program, and guys, here you can see that it is showing my country name, because the phone number I have given is actually a Bangladeshi number, because I am from Bangladesh and I have to use a Bangladeshi number, so that's why it is showing my country name Bangladesh. So after our country name, I want to see the service provider name also. So for seeing this one, first from phone numbers, we have to import another module and it will be carrier. That's it. And here I want to extract the service provider name, so that's why we have to create a variable, and it will be service pro. And then we have to call our phone numbers dot parse, and then here we have to pass our number. So now we have to print the service provider name, so that's why let's print. And here first we have to call our carrier dot name phone number, and then here we have to give the variable name which we have created here. And then we have to give a language name, and it will be EN. That's it. Now if I run this again, here you can see that country is Bangladesh and the service provider I am using Ruby. So after the country name and the service provider name, now I want to see the location of this phone number in a Google map. So for doing this, let's close this one. First we have to install a package from Python. So that's why let's go to our terminal again. And here we have to again write pip install, and here we have to give the package name, and it will be OpenCage. That's it, and type enter. Now in a few moments, OpenCage will be installed in your computer. And guys, here you can see that we have successfully installed our OpenCage. So now close this one. So after installing the OpenCage, we have to now import the OpenCage in our project file. So that's why let's go to the top here. And here we have to import OpenCage. That's it. And after importing our OpenCage, now we have to import some packages from our OpenCage. So that's why from OpenCage.geocoder import, and here we have to import OpenCage geocode. So after doing this, we have to do another thing. We have to open our browser, and then you have to visit opencagedata.com. And from this website, you have to create a free account. After creating a free account, they will give you a dashboard, and inside your dashboard, you will find your API keys. So select the API keys. Here you can see that I have my API keys. Now I have to copy this key, and let's go to our text editor, and here we have to create a variable, and it will be key, and then we have to paste the API key. That's it. Now let's create a variable, and it will be geocoder, and then let's call our OpenCage geocode, and here we have to pass our key, and then let's take another variable, and it will be query, and it will be string, and here inside our this string we have to pass our location. And then we have to take another variable, and it will be results. Again call our geocoder dot geocode, and then here we have to pass our string formatted query. That's it. And now let's print this and see what we are going to find. So here we have to pass results, and if I now run this program, and guys, here you can see that we have a latitude and a longitude. Now using these two values, we are going to find the location from our Google map. Now let's close this one, comment out this one. Now let's take our lat, and here it will be results, and I'm going to take our first value, so that's why it will be 0, and here we are taking a geometry, and the value we are taking is the latitude. Now simply copy this one and then paste it here. We are taking the longitude also, like this one. So that's why it will be longitude. Now copy this and then paste it here. That's it. Now let's print our latitude and longitude. Now let's run the program. So guys, here you can see that we have a key error. Here it will be actually LNG. Not LAG. Now copy this LNG and then paste it here and here also. Now let's run the program, and here you can see that we have our latitude and our longitude. So after getting our these values, now we have to install another package. So for installing another package, let's go to our terminal, and here we have to write pip install folium. Now in a few moments, this package will be also installed in your computer. And guys, here you can see that we have successfully installed our package. Now after installing, we have to import the package. So that's why we have to write here import folium. That's it. So after importing our folium, now we have to create a variable and it will be my map. And here we have to call our folium. And here inside our folium, we have a function which is map. And here we have to give our location. And the location equal to will be our latitude and our longitude. And here we have to add zoom as start and it will be 9. That's it. Now let's arrange the map. So for doing this, we have to call our folium and then we have to take our marker function. And here we have to give our latitude and the longitude. And then I will call our pop-up and this pop-up will indicate our location. And add to our map, which is my map. That's it. So after this one, now I have to save the map like any other files. So for doing this, we have to call our my map dot save, because I'm going to save this map inside my folder. So that's why save. And here we have to give a name for this file and it will be my location. Now remember one thing, the file name extension will be a HTML. It means this is going to be a HTML file. So that's why we have to write HTML. So if I run this program, we will have a file which is mylocation.html and this file will be saved in our project folder here. So now let's run the program. And guys, here you can see that our execution was successful. And here you can see that I have a file name which is mylocation.html. So now let's open the file and here you can see that it is a HTML file. Now here you can see that we have some browsers here. It means we have to select a browser and this HTML file will be shown in that browser. So I'm using Chrome, so that's why I will select the Chrome. And guys, here you can see that we have a map here. And here you can see that this is the location. So this is the location of that phone number. And here you can see that we have successfully tracked that phone number using a map. And I hope this Python project was helpful for you. And also I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. And if you really do, then please subscribe, like this video and press the bell icon for the future videos. And if you guys have any question about this video, please let me know in my comment section. That's it guys, let's see you in our next tutorial.